And I have pleasure to give the floor to the distinguished representative of Ethiopia, His Excellency, Mr. Mitiku Kasa Kutile, State Minister for Matters Related to Disaster Management and Food Security, Disaster Risk Management and Food Security Sector of the Ministry of Agriculture and Rural Development. Excellency, you have the floor.
Madam Co-Chair, thank you for giving me this opportunity. As you may all know, Ethiopia is one of the world's fastest growing economies. Nevertheless, natural and human-induced hazards and associated disasters continue posing a serious threat to our country, mainly because of widespread vulnerability and climate change. And this phenomena leads to a higher risk of losing hard-won development gains and growing food insecurity, as well as hindering progress towards eradicating poverty and attaining sustainable economic development. Recognizing this situation, the Federal Democratic Republic of Ethiopia has put disaster risk reduction and resilience building at the top of its development agenda. As a result, Ethiopia has endorsed the new disaster risk management policy and strategy in July 2013, which is followed by strategic planning and investment framework for its implementation. Ethiopia's disaster risk management approach is in line with the Hyogo Framework for Action, the African Regional Strategy for Disaster Risk Reduction and its Program of Action, and the IGAD Disaster Risk Management Program. Under this program, we have achieved a broad range of results over the past years, which we have reflected in the HFA Progress Report prepared based on the HFA Monitor Template and submitted to UNICDR Regional Office for Africa. Ethiopia believes that our government system has led to more successful implementation of the current HFA and the post-2015 framework for disaster risk reduction. Therefore, Ethiopia fully supports Africa's contribution to the post-2015 framework for disaster risk reduction with the following five issues taken into consideration to have due attention again in the post-2015 framework for disaster risk reduction. One, special emphasis should be given to agriculture research on crop pests and diseases controlling measures which are currently aggravated by climate change. In tropical weather, climate change has created conducive environment for breeding of pests and the multiplication of pathogens. Therefore, in order to maintain hard-won gains, ensure food and nutrition security, and achieve sustainable development, research in the framework of science and technology should be emphasized at national, regional, and international level. Two, social safety nets as part of DRR should be linked and integrated to livelihood enhancement program so as to ensure resilience to shocks at household and community level. Three, there has to be proper land use planning and administration at rural and urban areas in order to prevent and mitigate adverse effects of flash floods, land degradation, deforestation, and related disasters. Four, effective disaster risk reduction can only be achieved if disaster risk management is mainstreamed into every sectoral development plan. As disaster risk reduction is a cross-cutting issue and the responsibility of multiple sectoral institutions and those concerned bodies must implement by integrating it into their regular development activities. Therefore, disaster risk reduction should be mainstreamed into development plans of government institutions, non-government and private sector organizations. Five, effective disaster risk reduction requires strong cooperation and collaboration with relevant sub-regional, regional and global organizations and states. The cooperation should concentrate in particular on establishing a strong working relationship around capacity building and facilitating conditions for regular exchange of information for undertaking multi-hazard disaster risk monitoring and providing timely and comprehensive response. Therefore, international cooperation should be strengthened in accordance with the disaster risk reduction overall direction, relevant international, regional and national laws, directives and agreements. Finally, let me conclude my statement by expressing my heartfelt gratitude to all partners for their continued support toward this advancement of the DRR agenda in Ethiopia. I thank you for your attention.
I thank you, Mr. State Minister, for your statement.